Let's get into it. I stand before you as vessel, filled with love and truth. Chest lifted, eyes shifted, I posture myself as woman. Curved in places, cracked in some spaces, muddled, muddled of battle. Been held down, been called mere, little, and few. I've been challenged by men, stood up to by children. I tell you, I've been tested. I've been attacked by the same hands that slid rings upon mine. Been put down and been put upon. I tell you no lie, I've redefined struggle. And though my back stands straight and shoulders erect, make no mistake, it's not for lack of battle. Though I stand in the eye of tornadoes most days, I still stand because my people, we are physically and mentally built to carry enough water to feed villages through jungles while balancing it all on our heads. We are built to carry bushels through briars whilst walking barefoot and feeding babies bundled around our waist. I tell you, women are built for battle. Innately, we are expected to enter into warfare like soldiers drafted with no say-so. We read warnings, reporting for duty, performing our daily PT while giving and receiving counsel from our fellow platoon mates. I sometimes stand before you stretched to the limits of my soul. I sometimes feed my children standing over pots stirring dinner while my mind spins. I sometimes feed myself in limbo, not knowing whether my silence is in wisdom or confusion, not sure if my life is in true or continuous struggle, or if Satan is battling my spirit with pure delusion. But God has built me in a way that walks like no other. All I must do is ask, and all he is asking me to do is stand. Crumble beneath my feet while I run through skipping, girded with his power, with his sauntering power, with his pure definition of grace. His mercy lives through me. That's why mothers, grandmothers, sisters, wives, we are blessed with the ability to fight in peace. See, our mates lead us to stand strong and hold our backs up as they toil. Our children need our strength and guidance, need our yeas to be yeas and our nays to be nays in peace. Mm-hmm. We must hold it down and hold it together. It is only with outstretched hands can we receive this particular weapon that God has granted us with. His most powerful weapon for women is peace. But when we have our arms outstretched, expecting peace, granting peace, living in peace, when we collectively strive for perfected peace, we hold a weapon that no man can match. When a woman chases and chooses peace, the whole world has no choice but to come. With peace, we stand toe-to-toe with the fiercest of demons and fight them all with the love of God. We are here. We are women. We are peace.
Yes. Peace.
Sometimes I feel mm-hmm. like a motherless child. Sometimes I feel like a motherless child. Sometimes I feel like a motherless child. Alone. From home. Bitches and hoes gyrated their bodies dancing around man-made suns, praying to God, please don't let them catch me in the morning. Bitches and hoes screamed and cried while being shackled. Bitches and hoes were sold to different area codes, and for what? They say, everyone says it. It's become a term of endearment. Well, forgive me, I don't feel like hugging when you call me that word. See, to call a woman a bitch requires no effort. To then call that bitch a hoe requires no skill. How much time does it take to go platinum these days? Or is it true what they say? It just takes a couple of keys of coke and some borrowed studio time. You remember the rhyme. The challenge lies in all of us. Bitches and hoes standing up, breast to breast, drink sitting, butt to butt, and deciding it's the time to kill. Where's your will? Bitches and hoes slaved over stoves to feed children that weren't theirs while their own starved at home. Bitches and hoes clawed through the garbage of children that weren't theirs to clothe their own. Imagine if Maya was that bitch that paved my way phenomenally. If Angela was the bitch with the raised fist that gave me the right to say I'm a black woman and I am proud. Imagine if Betty was that bitch that hung by her nigga while he spit game to budding hustlers, pimps, baby daddies, etc. Imagine if Betty wasn't that bitch that Malcolm loved the most. She just was the bitch that hung around the longest, and once she got knocked up, it was just cheaper to keep her.
Come on. one.
These simple folk grew up in hoods just like yours. So what's their excuse for not using that verbal abuse while they built the movement? If we continue to be the deaf, dumb, and blind monkeys, flippantly flipping our hair, howling out bitch and hoe while our three-year-olds got nowhere to go except for the set of that new Step and Fetch It Back video, you act like you know. Ladies, that twinge you feel in the back of your brain when you're about to take your clothes off for some rapper that calls himself insane as your ancestors calling your name. Don't do it. Stand up for Nikki, stand up for Sonia, stand up for Maya, stand up for Asada. Pull your pants up, put your clothes on, look in the mirror. Stand up for Latifah. Hell, stand up for your motherfucking self. Pull your pants up, put your clothes on, and look in the mirror. Peace. SelahthePoet on Facebook, wherever social media is, that's where I am.
Yes.
You don't never make fun of my book. Let me tell you something real quick. And I love him, and I don't even know where we love each other from, but I'm telling you right now, we just broke up. He can come to the house, he can get his shit. I'm telling you. Ladies, body love. Who loves their body? So, this is a conversation I had with my thighs.
I'm over her.
I will show my thighs again, and when I do, it will be without regret or fear, in hopes that they will forgive me without remembrance. I will show them in love, in public. I will walk slow, proud of my jellied wobble. I will show my lumped legs in defiance. I will be unaware like a glistening mountain, proud of its caves and cliffs. I will show them, strut fiercely in surrender to their demand for unmuted lights and unmuffled air. I'll pretend I know them, supple and plump and other cute words. I will smile, ignoring my lumps. I will saunter in shorts, catering to my cellulite like it's perfect, like my thighs are dented like ripe melons, overly enjoyable. Today I will posture myself careless. I will call them by their preferred name, Curvy. While fused, I won't falter. Instead, I will cross my ankle. I will allow the sweet sweat to gather, creating a canal bordered by moist brown levees. I will celebrate the Milky Way of black stars dotted upon them, brushing my hands over the dimpled terrain, freeing the coils of hair hidden underneath. I won't flinch at random touch, no longer embarrassed and dented and way too big. I will believe them, my thighs. I will lift my skirt above my knees past the concave hollow space where my elbows have stood post, shielding my girlness down to bone. I will show my thighs again. I intend to gather my skirt, cup it in fabric in a spiteful, appeasing grip, and obey them, commanding me to rise from self-pity. My thighs will shout despite me, libertad, and salsa and freedom, and joyful and self-triumph. They will suck sun in like it's the last corner of sugared ice on the last popsicle on the last day of summer, twirling soul-like succulent rotisserie on the 4th of July when my thighs stretch themselves over grass, forcing me to lie down. I will do as they say. I will not bother them. I will be deliberate and pretty and closer to home. This is for calm.
I want to do I Am Hip Hop.
I am hip-hop, and I don't say that because I rock to the latest beats. I definitely don't spit that because I'm known for the most retweets. See, I am an original. I'm born between the cracks of concrete thighs, sworn to the fact that my ashes will never lie on the lips of some sucker MC. Because see, in my house, the first blend tape was begrudgingly passed around like a baby girl's first Barbie. It was caressed and coveted like that golden glow in Marsalis' trunk. It was consumed, deconstructed, renewed, and respewed like Avengers lunch. I said I am hip-hop. I'm not looking for anyone's street cred or approval, because see, my roots, they break you off themselves. I was there when Q-Tip found the Jungle Brothers, watched LL get stolen for his radio, and still rose up to rock the bells. My feet rock high top Reeboks, my lollipop position just right. I knew the appropriate amount of hair to part for my bangs, and I was solid in my position in the street lights for the word fights. Who's gonna be hot tonight? I politic through parks after dark. I knew the appropriate amount of place to stand when a cardboard box became a breaker's wonderland. I still write my name in bubble letters graffiti. I spit enough splits to sit amongst shirt kings. I consider myself a queen, thanks a lot, and I knew what it meant when a chick just had to get rah-rah. I rocked rough and tough through hoods that weren't mine, sporting a my first Sony and a fresh pair of Calcanines. See, I was 3 feet high and rising. I knew when to romp it out and when to run. Knew it wasn't rockets that someone had a gun, but if Eric said freeze with the blow of a flute, everyone froze, no one dared to shoot. That was my jam. And now I stand for who I am. I am an original, true hip-hop head. And I won't be redefined by some dope boy sporting dreads because he thought it might make him official. I won't be defined as part of the past. Not till someone gets up and whips these youngins' ass. See, I call for revolution. And since I'm second generation and not the first, I'll ask blessings from KRS and won't forget not to curse. But there's a war going on in the name of the word. These blasphemous, bureaucratically born, bogus bastards must be battled. Now who's gonna carry the flag? See, the elders taught us to fight the power no matter what whip you drove or your fucking swag. I said I am hip-hop. And conformity is not in our nature. We reinvented and renewed. We respected each other's views because the use of our muse was critical to whom we chose to follow. I swallowed spoonfuls of disrespect. Disregard for a culture that was brought up by and for intellect. And now the stereotype has come home to roost. Subliminal-minded, you've been blinded, looking for original thought and can't find it. Scratch heads and spins on when this retrograde of my culture will end. Left thinking if we're the smartest ones in our crew, then maybe it's time we got new friends. Or maybe soul like a crack in a window and they'll let us back in. True hip-hoppers know the lab is where it begins. And I don't care for no longer friends. Cause like any shit-kicking red, white, and blue country music fan, I will start a bar fight in here for my culture. I will whip out a can of 36 chambers and start hitting up coat hangers. I will tell my girls to go out and get my Vaseline, or better yet, I'll call these fake rappers mamas. Tell them to come get their chaps, cause this party and bullshit is over. Hip-hop, stand up.
You killed it!
Okay. Oh, man.